when evil seemed to have insuperable advantage in the long and bitter war with goodness, when the love ran out and demons scaled the heights of wrong, the Father gave the angels his command, the royal vigilance to be withdrawn. In that great jeopardy, the Father planned to sacrifice his king. The evil one did swiftly move unholy hearts through spite. In recompense for all the injuries past, while angels, suffering not his foot to strike an errant stone, were witnesses, aghast like Peter, who cried out, "It shall not be!" to nail the Father's darling to the tree.
Thank you.
while feckless Pilate paced within, outside the angry crowd, refusing to dismiss their hate, cried out, "Let him be crucified!" Yet Jesus, now betrayed by Judas' kiss, abandoned by his friends, by Peter thrice denied, in tattered regal robes arrayed, and fitted with a thorny crown, the price he for his mocked and scorned kingship paid, petitioned God's forgiveness for them all, because he prayed they knew not what they'd done. The Lamb was slain for them on Calvary's knoll. His stripes healed sinners, and his blood atoned. We stand in sin exactly where they stood. For this, we dare to call this Friday good.
Thank you.
Beside the Lord, two criminals were hanged. One cried to him, "Aren't you the Christ? Then save us and yourself." Surprised, the other sprang to his defense. "Don't you fear God? They gave us the same hard sentence to us all, for me and you. 'Twas justly so, for we have got exactly what our deeds deserve. But he has done no wrong at all." In hope, he sought the Lord. "Remember me when you into your kingdom come." And turning, when their eyes met, Jesus said, "In truth, I say to you, today you'll be with me in paradise." Three crosses on a hill? Not what it seems. Because their cross condemns. His cross redeems. there followed Jesus women on the steep hill, weeping for their Lord who'd loved the poor. You daughters of Jerusalem, don't weep for me, he answered their lament, but for your children and yourselves. Behold, the days are coming. On the cross, he saw his mother near, and one who by her stays was the disciple whom he loved. He called to Mary, Woman, look upon your son. And to the other, here's your mother. Since that moment, when true fellowship was born, faith's families always by adoption. Hence the ones who hear and do the Father's will are all his brothers, sisters, mother still.
Thank you.
King David, writing in the Spirit, viewed Christ's crucifixion there unfolding upon Golgotha's hill. The imprecations spewed from wagging tongues that vainly mocked him on the cross. He trusted God. Where is God now? Below him, savages cast lots. His strength dried up. They pierced his hands. King David saw it all. Described his distant heir at length, prophetically. So, Jesus knew the road laid out for him. Gethsemane had taught him deep submission. When he felt the goad of anguish welling up, his flesh was fraught. But Jesus claimed and lived the prophecy. My God, why have you forsaken me? A wise man once proclaimed, if there had been a better thing, more profitable to health of men than suffering, Christ would surely have shown it by his word and by his example. Wealth can't buy what suffering gains, nor fame, nor power, nor elevated rank. The cup drunk to the bitter dregs, the grievous and the sour, bestowed obedient perfection through the suffering on the cross. The nails weren't enough to hold the God-man fastened to the tree. 'Twas only love that held him there. The joy set before him, he foreknew. The church redeemed. In pain, he scorned the curse. His racked and dying body cried, I thirst. Who has believed our message? For he grew up like a tender shoot. He had no form or beauty. Those attracted were but few. A man of sorrows, knowing grief, forlorn, despised, rejected. We esteemed him not. He bore our griefs, afflicted, wounded for our sins. The Lord has laid on him what ought to be our punishment. Alone, he bore it all to seal firm the new covenant in blood, real blood, his blood. The promises to Eve, to Abraham, to David meant the Lord this moment would our sins dismiss. He saw salvation's birth, and for that cause proclaimed that it is finished. So it was.
Thank you.
It was about the sixth hour. Over all the land, until the ninth hour, darkness fell. The sun was darkened, and the cross stood tall against threatening skies. His words came back to tell him what must be. For no one takes life from me. Of my own accord, I lay it down. Both priest and sinless victim, to become sin for us all, the sacrifice, the crown, the only Son of God released his life. Obedient to the Lord's salvation plan, the victory over death, the end of strife, then, Father, spoke the Lamb, into your hands I now commit my spirit. And his breath departed as he sank to mortal death. Behold, great signs and wonders now burst forth to claim the fears of witnesses abroad. At once, while in great tumult did the earth shake, rending rocks and opening graves with loud and terrifying claps, the temple veil was ripped in two. The earth gave up her dead, past saints that rose to life and shook the failed foundations deep. For lo, death's powers had fled. Those treasured words the enemy had worked so long to hear. Why have you forsaken me? Instead of victory over Jesus, marked the doom of hell's ambitions. Truly he, confessed the frightened soldiers, was the Son of God. The Father pledged, he is the one.